In this video, we are going to learn about the contracts with persons of unsound mind. So I request you to be patient and watch the video till the end so that you can learn something useful within the next few minutes. According to Section 10 of the Indian Contract Act, capacity of the parties to contract is one of the essential elements of a valid contract. We have a separate video on essential elements of a valid contract. If you have not watched that video, please do watch. You can find the link to that video in the description. If you already know about Section 10, which talks about essential elements of a valid contract, you can continue watching this video. Section 11 talks about the capacity of contract. According to Section 11, everyone is competent to contract except these three kinds of people. First one is minor. We have a separate video explaining the position of contracts with minors. You can find the link to that video in the description. Second one is a person of unsound mind. And third is persons disqualified by law. So remember that these three kinds of people are not competent to contract. In this video, we will focus on the point number two. People who are of unsound mind. Now you must be thinking, who is considered to be unsound mind or sound mind? To understand who is considered sound mind for the purposes of entering into a contract, we should read Section 12 of the Indian Contract Act. According to Section 12, a person is of sound mind if at the time of entering into the contract, he is able to understand the contract and can think rationally. For example, a person who is totally sane is drunk. When he is drunk, he will not be able to understand the contract, or he may not be able to think rationally about the consequences of the contract. Hence, he is not competent to enter into a contract when he is drunk. Now, what if a person is occasionally sound mind or occasionally unsound mind? According to Section 12, if a person is generally unsound mind but sometimes he becomes sound mind, in that case he can enter into a contract when he is of sound mind. Similarly, if a person is generally of sound mind but sometimes he becomes unsound mind, in that case he is not competent to enter into a contract. For the second case, we can take the example where a person who is totally sane but is drunk. When he is drunk, he will be considered unsound mind. So from these two provisions, we can understand that it is all about being able to understand the contract and its consequences at the time of entering into it. Now, when we have understood about the persons of unsound mind, you must be thinking about what happens if I enter into a contract with a person who is of unsound mind. You should remember that all the contracts entered into with people of unsound mind are not valid. They are void. I hope you have understood the position of contracts with people of unsound mind. That is it in this video. Thank you. Bye.